Hello everybody, my name is John Erkin and I'm a professor in the Chemical and Biological Engineering Department. I got my PhD at Texas A&M University and then joined the University of Connecticut Chemical Engineering Department as an assistant professor. Over there I worked for 11 years and then I was actually recruited by Koch University in 2006. Where I joined the Chemical and Biological Engineering Department. I worked actually in the area of nanostructured materials and their applications in a variety of fields.
In my opinion, today, university's success is measured by its research output. Therefore, best universities recruit the best scientific minds and provide them with a research infrastructure so that they can develop successful research programs that are recognized at an international level. Therefore, by studying in a research university, the students actually get the opportunity to be taught by the best professors in their fields. Naturally, they learn about what the current problems are and what needs to be developed in a particular field, and what kind of research is being carried out to tackle such problems. The students also get the opportunity to work on research projects in faculty members' laboratories and do hands-on research. This can be for one semester or it can be even for 4 years. For example, I had a student who started working in my laboratory as a freshman. She came to my office one day and then she said, "Professor Erkin, I heard that you have a good research program in nanotechnology and I'm very interested." And she started working with me. And she worked for 4 years in my laboratory. And then she ended up going to Georgia Tech actually for her PhD. I think especially elective classes are very interdisciplinary and the students get the opportunity to interact and work together with students from other disciplines. For example, I teach a course called Sustainable Energy, and it is attended by students from electrical and computer engineering, industrial engineering, mechanical engineering, chemical and biological engineering, chemistry and physics. And so this way, students understand the interdisciplinary nature of science and engineering fields.
Chemical and biological engineering program tries to equip the students with skills so that they can go ahead and formulate solutions to problems in many areas related to chemistry and biology. I will try to give you some examples. Curing diseases such as cancer, preventing global warming, making chemical processes more efficient, terraforming Mars, making batteries for electric cars more efficient and cheaper, and manufacturing computer chips on a massive scale. In our program, the students take both science and engineering classes to achieve these skills. Mathematics, physics, chemistry, biochemistry, and biology are science classes. Thermodynamics, fluid mechanics, heat transfer, mass transfer, biochemical engineering, process control, and process and product design are the engineering classes. The program at KU is unique because it is the only chemical and biological engineering program in Turkey. The engineering classes are formulated in such a way that biological examples are integrated to these classes. If you like, you can also get a certificate in advanced materials or energy and environment or biotechnology and bioinformatics by completing actually 4 classes in each track. So we think that this is a good way for the students to spend their elective classes. So our faculty carries out research in many diverse areas. So students can participate in projects related to bioinformatics, protein-protein interactions, energy, microbiology, process dynamics and control, biotechnology, tissue engineering, polymer science, and catalysis. Many of our graduates continue with post-graduation studies. Approximately half of these students go to scientific fields, and half of the students go to non-scientific fields such as economics, marketing, and business administration. Many of our graduates go abroad for a PhD to really good universities. Students who carry out research in faculty members' laboratories especially end up in world-class programs. We had students going to Georgia Tech, University of California at Berkeley, Stanford, Carnegie Mellon, and Princeton. Actually, one of our graduates who completed her PhD at Stanford got hired as an assistant professor at Caltech. That really shows the quality of our students in our program. In the Chemical and Biological Engineering Department at Koç University, we also have a master's program and a PhD program. Our graduates can also attend these programs. Actually, some of the students that I mentioned to you before who went on to PhD actually got their master's degree at Koç University. Our graduates find employment in a wide variety of sectors, which include food, pharmaceutical, electronics, chemical, textile, paper, materials, and energy industries. For me, Koç University is the best university in Turkey, and it provides an excellent learning atmosphere for the students. Well, it was very nice talking to all of you. I hope to see all of you at Koç University in the near future. I wish all of you good luck.